Good day everyone. Today we will discuss about the VLAN connection for your Wi-Fi vendo machine. Let us go ahead and start. So what we have here is a new Wi-Fi router that has already been configured for open access. You can see here a white LAN wire. This one is gonna be connected to our OPI board here. Just follow this, and as you can see, this is connected to the OPI board. And we have here a Mercosis that has been configured to serve as an access point. This also has a blue LAN wire, and this is connected to a USB to LAN adapter. And as you can see here, the USB cord is also connected to the OPI board. Now let us go ahead and access the new Wi-Fi router. And for this one, go to switch, and then on this one we need to create a VLAN ID. For this one, name it under as 22 because we will be using it later. Now go ahead and open your Wi-Fi. As you can see here, we have an AdoPiSoft hotspot that is visible. This one is the USB to LAN connection under our Mercosis access point. And under that, we see the AdoPiSoft hotspot VLAN 2.4G. This is actually our new Wi-Fi router that we will be using, and we will be tagging as the VLAN. Now we need to go back and connect to the AdoPiSoft hotspot and access our admin dashboard. Go to network, and under the 802.1Q or VLAN, we will create a VLAN connection under here. So first we will need to create an interface alias. We can name it in any way we want, but for today we will use VLAN test 22. Now click enable captive portal, and then for maximum hop set it to 1, and then for the parent interface choose the ETH 0, and the VLAN ID tag we used 22 earlier, so that is what we will also use today. Uncheck the dynamic address, and then for the static IP address we will use 20.0.0.1. And for the network prefix, we will use 20. Now we will enable the DHCP server on this one. For the pool start, start from 20.0.0.10. And for the pool end, you can choose 20.0.0. How about 20.0.15.254? And after you are done setting up, click the create VLAN option on the lower end. Now that the VLAN has been created, let us go to interfaces, and then scroll down on this one, click ETH1, and what we are seeing here is the USB to LAN connection with the IP address of 10.0.0.1. but first, before we proceed, we need to reboot the machine so that the changes can be applied. And after the reboot, we will now go ahead and connect to our dashboard. We are still accessing the dashboard using our USB to LAN connection, as you can see with our IP address that is 10.0.0.1. We will try to access our dashboard this time using the VLAN connection, which has the IP address of 20.0.0.1. And as you can see here, our IP address this time is 20.0.0.1, because we are accessing the machine through the VLAN connection. And right now we can access the machine through the two separate connections, one through the VLAN and one through the USB to LAN. The connections have different IP addresses. The other one is operating under 10.0.0.1 and the other one is operating under 20.0.0.1. Now, there is also actually a way that we can access the machine through the two connections, but both of them will share the same IP address by creating a bridge. So go to interfaces and click create bridge. This is where you can set up that. So you scroll down and you go to interface alias, and then you can name it in any way you want, but for this video we will name it as bridge test 1. For the hubs, you also need to set it to 1. You click the enable captive portal. For port and interfaces to bridge, check ETH1 and ETH0.22. And for the IP address, do not check the dynamic IP address because you want it to be static. And we will be using the one that is used on the USB to LAN. You will go ahead and click create bridge by then. Now that the bridge has been created, the VLAN connection and the USB to LAN connection should have the same IP address by now. We just need to restart the machine and check after that. So we have now applied the settings. And for this one, let us connect to the VLAN connection and let us go ahead and try to access the machine using the IP address 10.0.0.1. And as you can see, we were now able to access the machine using the IP address of the USB to LAN connection, which is the 10.0.0.1, because we have successfully bridged the VLAN and the USB to LAN connection for this machine. And to prove that, we will also connect to the AdoPiSoft hotspot. This is the USB to LAN connection earlier, which had the 10.0.0.1 original IP address. And as you can see, we can also access the machine using the same IP address even if we were connecting to the USB to LAN or to the VLAN connection. Now, if you decide to remove your VLAN and your bridge connection, we will also teach you on how to do that. So as you can see here, we cannot access the VLAN settings right now because it has been bridged. So what we need to do is we need to go to the interfaces and go ahead and click the bridge test 1 and then uncheck the ETH0.22 so that the VLAN connection will not be bridged to the USB to LAN connection. After that, you should be able to access your VLAN connection, and as you can see, this is now not bridged, and this is where you can click the remove VLAN. so that the VLAN will be removed from your connection. To apply these settings, go ahead and reboot the machine. And I hope you have learned something today regarding the VLAN. That would be all. See you next time and have a good day.